Mr. Armakopoulos, is there an interest among Greek public concerning latest political developments in North Macedonia?
Yes, in the last few days we have a lot of public interest. The Greek press is following very closely what's happening in North Macedonia. And I have to say also the opponents of the agreement in newspapers and increasingly politicians who are criticizing the government are using this opportunity to raise the issue of Greece withdrawing from the agreement or abolishing the Prespa agreement. So this is for them an opportunity, this political crisis in North Macedonia.
Do you believe that Greek government can block further EU integration of North Macedonia if potential new government in Skopje does not fully implement and comply with the provisions in the constitution and in Prespa agreement?
Well, listen, the alternate Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Vavitsiotis, has already mentioned a couple of days ago that Greece will reconsider its position, although it may change its position on North Macedonia's EU integration course, if there is nationalist rhetoric and not full implementation of the Prespa agreement. So this has already been stated officially. And I think those forces who are against the Prespa agreement, and they are within a Demokratia, within New Democracy Party, including a former, at least one former prime minister, will pressure hard, you know, for the government to actually have a very strong reaction to any such incidents coming from North Macedonia.
What kind of strong reaction do you mean?
Well, I mean, by strong reaction, I mean, at the very least, not being so friendly to North Macedonia and not being supportive of the EU accession process. But as I have already mentioned, there is a constituency within the Demokratia that would like to see the entire agreement being abolished and all the commitments that come with it.
Leader of VMRO-DPMNE Christian Mitsotakis, in his latest interview, stated that he will not repeat the adjective as often as Zoran Zaev did, meaning North Macedonia, while at the same time saying that Prespa agreement is reality. If this is the approach of Mitsotakis as a possible future prime minister, will Athens consider it as sufficient?
It's a pity that we're having this interview today, because I think this statement by Mr. Mitsotakis will be in the Greek newspapers tomorrow, and certainly will not be very well received, because essentially what Mr. Mitsotakis is implying is a kind of double talk, that they will try to implement the agreement or respect the agreement, but not using the new name North Macedonia. I think the Greek side has made it very clear that when they say respect the agreement, they mean use of the new name North Macedonia rather than just Macedonia. And I think as soon as they see top politicians in the country, prime minister and ministers, using Macedonia instead of North Macedonia, they will immediately react. I think we will go back to very bad temper between the two countries and other consequences that I have mentioned earlier. So I don't think this is an option. I think any government in Skopje, if they want to continue building good relations with Greece and having Greece's support to the EU integration process, they need to fully respect the Prespa agreement, including the use of the new constitutional name, North Macedonia.
Thank you very much for this interview.